Hello, my name is Eddie Fawcett. I'm the owner of Tuatahi Racing Axes and Saws. We're being asked repeatedly to demonstrate how our axe and saw filing jigs work. We've decided to do a video for you with just the basics of axe repair and saw repair. Tonight we're going to demonstrate the axe filing jig. We're going to show you how we get an axe working that has just gone a little bit dead. We will show you how we stone an axe in the saw filing jig, and also how we file an axe. We'll also show you how we fit handles. So I sincerely hope that you get something out of this video. The item of equipment that we're going to demonstrate tonight is the axe filing jig, and this is the equipment here. Pretty simple piece of equipment, but if you're really serious about getting into wood chopping, it's a must for all competitors. The first thing we've got to learn when we're using the filing jig is to find the correct radius to put the center punch mark on that fits on this little pin here. Most axes from Tuatahi are ground on a diameter of 14 inches or 350 millimeters. So we've got to find half that, either 7 inches or 178 millimeters. And we do this here by a simple little tool, tungsten carbide tip, a plastic end that's adjustable. It's set at 7 inches or 178 millimeters. Scroll it on each corner with it right out at the extremes of the corner. Where those lines cross over, you put a center punch mark. That center punch mark is important too. You must make sure that you have it in the same distance. If you really hit one and it goes in a long way, your axe won't file up evenly, so it's important that that depression is exactly the same. The first axe we're going to file in the jig tonight is an axe that's come in to be filed. It's got a polished chisel on it, and the customer wants me to file a chisel for a different type of wood. It's already been scribed with a center punch mark. The filing jig just fits in a vise. Tighten those locating things up. It's important that the axe is on both of those adjusting screws under there. This doesn't need to be tightened too tight, just nipped up, making sure that the axe is hitting both sides. As I mentioned before, it's important that these are level. The file is inside this clamp here. It goes into that locating screw there. Now this, I'm screwing this down to get the right height. That looks roughly right, but what we've got to do now is put some engineer's ink onto the chisel to be filed so that we can see exactly what we're doing. This is most important when you're doing any work on an axe. You must know exactly what you're doing, making sure that you're filing in the correct place. On this particular axe, I'm not altering the degrees, I'm just following what's on there. Move it very gently, and it's too tight, still too high. Now I've gone too far. Okay, that's pretty well perfect. This axe is filing reasonably well. If you find you've got an axe that's very hard to file, you can just tip the file up just a little bit. But you only do that until it starts to bite, and then you drop it, because the thing that you're trying to do is get that chisel dead flat. Now the other thing you must not do, now that you've started to file that, you must not touch that with your fingers, otherwise you'll get a greasy surface on there. And if you've got an axe that's really hard, there's no way you're going to be able to file it. I'm just going to lower that filing jig a little bit more. A little bit more engineer's ink. It's also important that you work the full blade. It's not an easy thing to do, to file an axe, especially if they're quite hard. Some axes that haven't been filed, it's very hard to get the file to grip, and you've got to just try and turn this up a little bit until it bites in. Once you get it filing, just keep the file dead flat. Now when you're freshening up an axe, after the edge has probably been honed 4 or 5 times and it's got too thick, and you've got to thin it down, you don't have to come to a feather edge, but you've got to get very close to it. Okay, now that side's pretty well finished as far as the file goes. Now that's the file has left it reasonably coarse. I don't like the chisel being too coarse. And there's various ways you can smooth it down. A lot of competitors now at this stage would get a little bit of wet and dry 600 grit paper, and they would just sit it underneath the file, get it damp, and just work it backwards and forwards until they smooth that chisel down. How I'm going to do it now, I'm going to use a diamond block. To undo the adjustment screw. What we do now, we use diamond paper that's glued to the block of a machined piece of steel. It has a groove machined in the back that fits on the arm of the filing jig. The diamond paper is glued to it. We can supply these blocks in all sorts of different shapes and radiuses and hollows. So some axes that are too hard to file, This is probably the only way of doing them. Now we've got to put our engineer's stamp on there again. Just a minute. Now the other thing that's important with the diamond block is that I don't like hanging it out too much past the edge. I like it back level with the edge. Okay, it's got to come down. It should be perfect. Now this must have just a little bit of water on it. If I do bring it out, I don't do very much. While it's hanging out over the edge, I bring it right back level. Okay, I'm going to put more engineer's glue on there now. Ink. When you're repairing axes, it's something that you want to take a lot of time. It's filling up pretty good. This will smooth the grooves that I put in with the file. And when you've got a new diamond on the block, it will take those grooves off very quickly. Right back to square. Okay, that side is finished. What we've got to do now is scribe the other side of the axe, put the center punch mark in, and we do the whole thing over again on the other side. You'll notice that this axe has got the handle in. That's the beauty of the filing jig. You can do quick repair jobs with the handle still fitted to the axe. Saves a lot of time. Another thing that happens, and this will show up on the next axe that I do, is that your edges get rippled. Now it's very hard to see, but the axe just stops cutting. 10 minutes with the filing jig and that'll be repaired, and you've got a top axe again. Okay. This side is finished. Now this axe here, we've got a problem with. I was using it a couple of weeks ago and I hit a very hard knot and it just seemed to stop cutting. Now it looks perfect. You can't see anything the matter with it. But when I run my stone across the edge, I can feel a bump there, which means that the edge is not true. And it's starting to show up where it's hit the knot. The edge is gone like that. Now I'm going to put this in the filing jig and see if I can show you how bad it's bent and how easy it is to get an axe going again. Same deal, make sure it's level here. Looks good. Engineer's ink again. This is a banana grind axe too, so it'll take a lot of filing. Clamp on. Okay, I'm going to leave it at that for a while. Must tighten this lock nut up, otherwise this moves around all over the place. Okay, now what's happened? It's got quite a hollow here, just in this little bit here, and this corner has moved over like that. So it's no wonder it stopped cutting, and it's got another bump here. Unfortunately, you're probably not going to be able to see with the camera, but I've just got to keep filing this now until it comes true. The thing that you have to remember too with the filing jig is you just don't file the parts of the axe that are damaged. You've got to file the whole lot all the time. You've got to try and keep it true. It's still not up in the middle, so it's quite a bad bend. And this end is still not up here. Still got an eighth of an inch that hasn't come up there and there. Everything else has come up. which is quite incredible really, because you couldn't see very much the metal with that axe, you could only feel it with the stone. It's not right up at this stage, but I'm going to do some work on the other side. I don't like to do too much to one side of an axe. You better to come back to it. Right. There was three turns. Use ink again. Going to try and do the same amount of filing on this side. This side's going to come up a lot quicker because everything was bent this way. Sounds looking quite good. Axes can move too. Steel can move, you don't have to hit anything at times. We'll have an axe that's going really well one weekend, the next weekend it's just not quite there. This is one way of finding out if anything is wrong. Putting it in the filing jig and throwing the file around. It'll show up any little irregularities, especially if you use the engineer's ink. Thank you.
This axe here is a Tuatahi BF. It's forged out of Australian steel. And when we get it, the Tuatahi, we reforge it and put it through a special heat treatment program, and we get it as hard as we can. It's not that easy to file. But it is coming up quite nicely. Okay, I'm going to change my file now before I turn over to the other side. What I normally do with my files, most times I'm only filing half inch, 12 mil, up to 25 mil, 1 inch chisels, and I use just the end of the file, half about there, and then I cut that off. And that allows me to use the whole length of the file. You don't want your file sitting right up here. You only want just that, just the short bit working. In this case, it's got to work right up to there. The banana is a full banana, so it goes right up high. And I'll put a new file in, so I'll put the engineer's ink on again. Looks like you're using a lot of engineer's ink, but you're not. The average axeman, this bottle would last him his lifetime, probably. It's looking pretty good on this side. If you can actually see, if you really bend an axe, and you can see it, you can put the axe under the hot tap, warm it, and have a go at tapping that back. It depends on the hardness of the axe, whether you get away with it or not. Most axes are on the borderline. 59, 60 rock or C. And if you try and do it cold, you'll snap the piece out, which means the axe has got to be reground. But it's worth a try. It saves a lot of axe and a lot of filing. Turn this over to this other side finished. Three turns again. Thank you. Yes, all nice and even. Getting closer now. About me, is that? Now it looks like I've done an awful lot of filing on that, but I'm only just getting a feather edge on it now, so. It hasn't gotten the axe to any great extent. So if you feel that you've done more work on one side, even if it doesn't need it, go back and do a bit to the other. Try and get the blade even. All I'm doing now is just trying to smooth out the grooves. Get the axe as smooth as I can before I put the diamond on it. Good. Right, we're going to change that back over to the diamond. Good. coming up quite smooth. The diamond is probably better after it's done one or two axes. This is a new piece here. Just using the diamond as a polishing and smoothing operation, it's better when it's quite a bit worn. There'd be other types of diamond stones you could use on here as well. And there'd be other ways of doing this too. You could use, you could cut a small piece of stone. You could break a small piece off like that, but the critical part of this is you could not have it hanging over the edge because the stone wears a groove and wouldn't be long before you'd end up with an axe that was rolled right over and all sorts of different shapes. You've got to keep it back, and you can bring it over for a few strokes, but you've got to keep it moving backwards and forwards, and most of the work has got to be done up flush. Then your stone will wear evenly. For a stone to cut on Tuatahi axes, it's got to be a stone that's quite soft. Otherwise you'll just rub there all day and nothing will happen. If the stone is cutting, it'll also wear. So you don't worry about, if you get a stone that's wearing away, you can be sure that it'll be cutting the material as well. So it's what you've got to have. Okay, well that's near enough for me to actually polish now and do the edge. I've got to do the other side, but that's the basics of using the filing jig with the file. In our last session we showed you how to file in the filing jig and how to stone axes. Tonight we're going to show you how to finish off a flat axe, which is the basic axe that'll cut most woods as long as the edge is correct on it, and it's the easiest one to do. I'm not sure if you can see here, but you've noticed we've taken the sides out. This is basically to relieve it and let it slip into the wood a little bit easier and to take some weight off. You've just got to scribe your axe. I've done this about 25mm. This one here is probably just a little bit more than that. It just depends on your preference and how much weight you want to take off that axe. Most of you will have a 4-inch grinder, which is a simple tool like this. You've got to have a stone to grind these pieces out. And then you change your stone to a 60 grit fibre back disc to polish it up. After the axe is, after you've polished it, you've then got to change to this is 120 grit, even up to 150, and just gently go over the axe, but don't go anywhere near the edge with these sorts of polishing wheels, because they're cutting, and go very lightly at it. When you've done that, you can then turn this 60 grit fibre back disc up the other way, get some medium polishing soap, and while the axe is warm, spread the polishing soap onto the axe and polish with the opposite side of the 60 grit fibre back disc, and that will really polish your blade up. But once more, don't go anywhere near the edge. Okay? When you grind the sides out of the axe, it's important that you don't go too far.
I haven't ground very much out of this axe. You could go to within 1.5 millimeters of this edge in here and right up to here, but no more than that. You've got to leave a decent amount of metal here. By actually taking that into 1.5 mils, it will take an awful amount of weight out of that axe and also relieve it quite a bit to let it slip into the wood.